I'm here with boxing star Brandon Rios, fresh off his victory off Diego Chaves. Brandon, how did you like fighting the WWE star Diego Chaves?
Not fresh off my victory, fucking off my fresh off my DQ qualification.
Not you didn't get DQ'd.
Yeah,
John Cena did.
That motherfucker did. It was crazy, man. You know, dirty fighter. Dirty fucking fighter, man.
For those who didn't see it on TV, because TV doesn't catch the angle, what happened in the ring?
It's because, you know, he right away, I don't know why for the first round. I know why, but I'm not going to say shit. But the first round, he knew to go for my arm. So right away, he went for my arm. And when he had my arm, he had my arm, then he goes like this. He lifted up right here on my elbow.
He was trying to break your elbow.
He was trying to break my fucking elbow. So the smart thing to do is when he goes like this, I'm going like this.
To keep the distance.
I put my head in the chest so he can stop.
He couldn't get any leverage.
So he can't even leverage, so I put my head in the chest and I lift up like that so he can fucking stop. And he kept doing it and he got, oh, he hit my head. And so that's what happened. And he said that I was the one that was fighting dirty. He said, no, motherfucker. For the first round, you kept grabbing my fucking hand. And so the smart thing to do is just put my head on his fucking chest and say, hey, bitch, let go. I'm gonna fucking go higher.
Now, dude,
and even one of the rounds, you seen it. And one of the rounds, I seen the replay. He goes like this, then he goes like this. He tried to fucking headbutt me, that motherfucker, dude. I was like, this motherfucker.
Tell me about him poking your eye.
Yeah. And then, see, he had me like this. Then he gave me a headlock. Then he cut my nose and everything. But, you know, you can't do it, but inside the gloves, you go like this. He was going like that with my fucking eye, dude. Then I was like, hey, motherfucker, my fucking eye, bitch. You know, I kept telling the referee, this motherfucker's poking my eye. I even went back to the corner, hey, Robert, this motherfucker's poking my eye. I kept telling Robert that. And finally, the referee paid attention to it, and he seen it, and he disqualified.
Well, I was telling people, a lot of people agreed with me, that when the referee took a point away from you, it was just a makeup call. Mm. It was just because he felt like, oh, I took away a point from Chavez, let me take a point from Rios.
When he took a point from me, when he took the point away, I didn't know what the fuck for. All I was, the thing that I was taught by Big G and Robert, when you're on the rope, just turn around and get off the rope. That's all I did. I was on the rope. I turned around and he fell. And I didn't know where I pushed him because he had my fucking hand. So when he fell, I was like this and he fell. And then they took a point away from me. I was like, what the fuck did I do?
Barry, tell me about the sequence where he did the MMA move. What was it called? What did Robert call it?
DDT. Well, he fucked up my neck. Look, I'm doing third grade on it.
What's DDT like?
He fucking
backflip.
Bones. He's not even on the fucking ground.
What did you tell him right after that? You told him something.
I went to the hospital. I had a light concussion because I started seeing blurry in the locker room because this eye was really blurry. And because when he did it, I hit the top of my head hard on the canvas. And then I turned over and I went to Max. I was like right there, I tried to get up. They're not Max, and they see me. I was like, oh, fuck, dude, what the fuck? And then I had a little trauma to my neck because the T-bone where it holds the neck. And, well, I don't know what it's called, but where it holds the neck and the shoulder blade, where that little fucking thing is, that's where it happens.
So let me ask you this. What do you think of all the shit that he's talking after the fight? Like, I don't know why I got disqualified. I beat him up. He's a punching bag. Before, he wasn't talking shit at all. It's funny. Like, after the fight, he felt like a big man.
It's because he didn't have to go in the ring anymore.
He grew up some balls.
Fucking is what it is. He felt that he think that he did nothing wrong. Well, he's a dumb fuck because he know he did something wrong. He know he was doing something wrong. He know the whole fucking time. If I done something wrong, I will fucking admit it. I done something wrong. But like I said, the smart thing, maybe I was doing it wrong. Maybe I fucked up by putting my head on his chest. But, you know, I was trying to not get my fucking arm broken because he was lifting up. So the smart thing to do, put your head on his chest.
Okay, Big G just told me a fighter that's dirty like that does not deserve a rematch. Would you want Ruslan next?
You know what? Honestly, like I tell everybody that, Cameron Duncan and Robert, they pick out the fights.
Garcia picks out the fights, right?
Whatever Cameron Duncan says, and that's what I do. He'll agree with Robert.
Let's ask Robert Garcia, what do you think?
Not me.
Not you?
Cameron picks out the fight. He talks to Robert about it, and Robert agrees to it, and we'll agree to it.
But Brandon, how do you think you did in the ring? You landed some good uppercuts?
I don't know, dude. I had my ring rest. I still felt it. I felt it.
So there you have it from the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy Knockstart for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ali Sekback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter @Sekback.